Don't get too carried away boosting around on this map because, well, you may just fall off the damn thing. Hi everyone and welcome to another episode of Mapped Out. This is the Mapped Out Gamer and today I'll be taking a closer look at the multiplayer map Green Band in Advanced Warfare. Let's get started. I did want to mention something quickly before we get started. All my new footage is being recorded at 60 frames per second, so I would highly recommend using a browser that supports that 60 frames per second playback in YouTube. This way you can have the best experience while watching my videos. Now that we got that out of the way, so atop of a high skyscraper, Green Band is set in South Korea. This is a city map, so we get lots of sharp lines and cool looking color palettes all throughout. The theme of the map is more like a modern Asian deco flavor. It's like a new age Zen garden look. I really like this theme and I felt it fit quite nicely for the area it was in. Everything seems to have its own place in this map. Nothing to me really sticks out as an eyesore. The weather system in this map isn't intrusive at all. It's a really nice sunny day, prime for positive battle conditions. Green Band is a simple map in terms of environmental interactions. We get no levolution events nor a specific map score streak. The layout of Green Band is set up as a classic three-lane map with the north and south headquarters. The north end roundabout building, aka the aquarium, has limited window peeking areas on each floor. This building is enclosed and has a more conventional entry point, such as the doorways. In direct contrast, the south end building, aka the restaurant, has long vertical windows with lots of openness. This results in a lot more ways to infiltrate this area. The lane to the east is made up of broken sight lanes with tall obstacles to navigate around. The small little waterfall up in the north end is a little finicky to travel around, so I would kind of avoid it. It just kind of interrupts the map flow, I think. The middle lane is similar in that it has a straight shot from the front door of the aquarium to the front door of the restaurant. This lane as well breaks up the sight lanes with larger obstacles varying in size. The westmost lane is the curveball that's kind of thrown into this map. It has a lane that breaks up into two smaller ones with varying levels. And if you go one step up in verticality, there's a lane that travels parallel to this lane. The top lane also has some smaller rocks speckled throughout for good cover opportunities. Speaking of verticality, Green Band operates on two major horizontal planes. The ground floor is evident as you traverse the center parts of the map, boost up a level on hello uninterrupted sight lanes. Areas like atop of the east of the aquarium are great to snipe from, allowing for a clear view of the entire map. The central obstacles allow for what I call island hopping. This is where you can hop from one obstacle to another instead of taking the conventional floor route. With the added boosting abilities, it feels natural to want to zigzag across the middle lanes, but this does come with a cost. One untimely boost and there you go, falling into a dead zone. This was pretty clever of the map designers to set up this risk-reward type of route. You know, sometimes it's frustrating, but still pretty clever. Green Band offers a little bit of everything to each weapon class. Medium to longer range weapons will do well if they stick to the higher playing field. If you like to rush, go ahead and load up an SMG to gain the upper hand in the lower central lanes. Green Band is a speedy map that offers lots of obstacles to boost over. Since this map is overall smaller in size, the areas of high traffic will vary, although the main contending areas would be the aquarium and the restaurant. It's really easy to be spotted traveling the center routes from these vantage points, so double check your six. Overall, Green Band is a speedball type of map with great contending center lanes. You may want to boost across lane to lane in order to keep your enemies guessing. Just be careful with the dead zones. If you're not feeling so dodgy, just go ahead and hang back atop of the higher playing field to get a better positive overwatch of this map. As always, check out the link below in the description to download your free interactive PDF map that shows all of the objective points for this map. If you enjoyed my work and my video, please give a thumbs up, or better yet, hit that subscribe button. And if you want early access to my digital content, then go ahead and follow me on Twitter at MappedOutGamer. Have a good one.